Hi guys, my name's Will. I'm from Weldclass down in Australia, and with me today, I've got Angus from First Light Fab.
G'day, mate.
Hey. So, what is it you guys do down here at First Light?
All right, so we do a lot of marine fabrication, customize and fit out boats, aluminium, stainless, all that sort of thing. So,
awesome. Yeah. Bit of fun stuff. Yep. Do you guys MIG much aluminium in the workshop?
Yeah, we do plenty of AluMIG.
Yep. All right, well, if it's cool with you, man, what I wanted to do today is I wanted to take some time to talk about MIG welding aluminium. Now, there's a few different ways we can do that, and I know it can be a bit tricky for those starting out for the first time. So I was thinking we talk about normal aluminium MIG, we'll do a little bit on Synergic aluminium MIG, we'll talk about MIG welding with a spool gun, and then we'll wrap it up at the end with a bit of a talk about pulse welding aluminium. We're going to get started out and do a little bit of MIG welding. I think it's good that we start with just basic MIG first.
Sure.
Yep. That'd be the first place to go to.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
All right. So I've got a 200 amp machine here. We've got a few things in front of us. We're going to go through how we would set up. So even if this is your first time using your MIG welder for aluminium, this will be the steps that we need to do. Where do we start with that, Angus? What's the first thing we're going to do to set up?
All right, so we'll start with your MIG wire, all right? So obviously we're going to need some aluminium. And then moving on, so we got our rollers.
Mm-hmm.
You need to swap those out. So typically people will be running V-rollers for their mild steel.
Yep.
We need to swap those out to a U-groove. So
okay.
The reason being is aluminium is quite soft, so it can deform with your V-rollers.
Now, when we get down to the gun, are we just putting the gun in like normal as if we're welding steel, or is there something else we're changing here?
No, so we need to change our liner also. So you're going to want to use a Teflon liner, but there's also graphite liners.
All right, so we're going to kick off with the first step, which is the drive roller.
Yes.
How do we get that one started?
All right, so you're going to loosen your tensioner and drop that away. This one's got a little retaining lock on it. Release that. Remove your V-groove roller.
So take the V-groove roller out.
Yep. And then take your U-groove. It does say AL on it, so that indicates it's for aluminium. All right, so we place that in and lock that back in place, and moving on. So
now, you've also got to match your roller to your wire size. Now, that is an important step. If you have the wrong size roller for the wire that you're running, you're going to have slip issues, or you're going to have the same problem where we crush the wire and it gets too thin. What's our next step, mate? What are we
all
moving
right,
to?
Let's put the spool of aluminium wire in there. So
spool of wire in.
Yep, retainer, tighten that up.
Is there a certain, like, do we want to go really tight when we're putting the wire spool on? Like, so is there a spot where it can slip too much?
I mean, you've got to remember that it's not, you don't want to lock it in place, right? So
yeah,
it needs to spin freely. So you want to just take it firm, but not
too far.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, cool.
All right, so let's set up the gun and the liner.
So we've got our gun here.
Yep.
I'll give you that end.
Sure. We've got our Teflon liner here. So that's what we're going to put in for our aluminium welding.
So we've got a few parts to this liner kit.
Sure.
This is a universal. There's different ones out there, but the main thing is that you get something that suits your machine. So that might be a universal Teflon kit like the one that we've got here, or it might be a brand specific one depending on the machine that you've already purchased.
Mm-hmm.
That'd be something that you take up with the dealer where you got your machine.
Now, they generally give you quite a long length. It has to be trimmed down, so keep that in mind.
Take the old liner out.
Yep. All the way.
So what we're doing here is we're starting to thread the liner back into the base of the mid gun and run it all the way through to the gun end.
Yes, that's right.
So we're going to take this off,
yep.
Take it apart,
yep.
Break it down.
Mm-hmm.
So we've got our mid gun here. Start with our shroud, which is the outer piece. We're going to take a shroud off.
All right, I'm going to hand you a spanner.
There you go. So we need to take the tip holder off, not just the tip. So next one down, if you've got MIG pliers, you can probably do this with your MIG pliers as well. That piece out.
All right, I'm going to push this liner through, and there we go. You see it come through there.
So you can see that liner comes out.
All right, now we take the neck liner. Now every machine is going to be slightly different, but this one has a little thread on here. We just thread that down onto the liner, as many turns as you can get it. So that's nice and firm on there now. All right, so we send that back down through the other way. I might get you to do that.
Put that back in there.
Yep.
Now, okay. Once we get down close, we'll take our tip holder again, put that on the liner, and feed in the last little bit with the tip holder. Once we've done that, shroud, back on.
All right, so then we've got this collet at the other end and O-ring. So let's bring this collet down.
Would it be fair to say that all these little things are what's going to make the difference when you're actually welding?
Yeah.
Like, so if you don't get the O-ring right or we get the space wrong at the end, is that going to make a difference in the weld?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you could get some hold up in there and, yeah, it'll affect your weld. But so with this backing nut, you want it firm to obviously engage that collet, but don't overdo it. You know, it's just to hold it there in place.
Hold that in place.
And then trimming this liner down, it's machine specific, you know, so just check your machine specs and trim it to suit.
A tip for some machines is you take a little bit of that excess and try and tuck it up inside there so it runs all the way up to where the wire comes off the drive roller, and that'll give you a really smooth feed into your MIG gun all the way through to your head.
Yep. Alrighty.
Plug her in. Now we've got to get the wire fed through to the end. What's the best way to go about doing that?
Now we just power on the machine. Okay, now some machines will have a jog feature, right?
Yep.
This machine doesn't. So all we're going to do is I'll basically straighten out this so it gets a nice smooth run, and then I'll get you to pull the trigger and run some wire through. All right.
Comes out of the tip like that,
mm-hmm.
and we're ready to go. We'll trim this down to size and we'll see how normal MIG welding works, and we'll get Angus to put down a weld. So we're all set up here now, guys. We're kicking off our first weld with just our basic MIG. So what we're doing here is we're balancing our volts and our wire speed settings. This is 040-5356 grade aluminium wire. We're running pure argon gas and we're welding with 1/8 aluminium 5005 welding coupons.
Yeah, so quite a nice weld, good penetration, probably a slight bit hot so we could turn down the voltage a little bit.
Cool. So we've just done our basic MIG weld, and I think what would be a really good step now is we're using the exact same machine setup, but we're going to have a look at Synergic.
Yep.
So Synergic or automatic is where the machine is just going to do those settings for us. So instead of playing around with the volts and the wire speed, we just tell it that we're working with this thickness of material, what wire we've got and our gas type. This guy takes care of the rest.
All right, so you can see here, there's a little improvement on that darkening around the outside and soot, so.
Yeah, that's definitely, like, it's helped. But the thing I like about it is we didn't need to play around with any of the settings. I just pressed like 2 or 3 buttons, so.
It really makes it easier.
If I'm at home and I've never done Synergic welding, or I've never done aluminium welding before, and I've got a machine like that, it's really click bang.
Oh yeah, it's easy. But
That's probably one of the easiest ways to get set up.
Mm-hmm.
The only downside to that one is we're still going to have to change our rollers and our drive liners versus the spool gun, but we'll have a look at the spool gun in a moment, mm-hmm. and we'll see how that changes the weld as well.
Yep.
So another thing with these manual machines, we don't have any adjustments in the start and the finish. So when you're looking at that weld, you'll see that right at the start of the weld, we look a little bit colder, a little bit mm-hmm. more raised up off the job, not quite as much penetration. Mm-hmm. And then when we get towards the end of the weld, we're getting that stereotypical kind of crater, mm-hmm. and we've got to muck around with how we're holding our gun and what we're doing with the wire to fill that crater. But as we move in towards our pulse machine, we're going to get a lot of settings that we can play around with and the pulse action itself that will help stop those little problems from creeping into the job. So we've just had a look at the two first forms of aluminium MIG welding. We've done the basic MIG weld, where we set the settings ourselves, and we've done the Synergic MIG weld, or the automatic, if you will, where it's done all the settings for us. Now, another extension of this is the spool gun. This is like the manual weld where we have to change the settings to suit, but the beauty of the spool gun is it gives us a bit of distance and we don't have to worry about those liners and rollers. Is that pretty fair to say?
Yeah, I mean, instances where we use it is whether we're gonna get inside a boat or can't get a machine into the area that we're welding, so we can have that advantage of the longer lead and everything like that.
We've got this pretty much the same settings we were just running before, but we've swapped over to a smaller roll of wire and a spool gun. Yeah, do you notice much difference between this and the normal manual?
I mean, it's a bit more cumbersome on the gun itself, it's very similar, you know.
So we've got the Pulse MIG out now. This machine really does so much more than the other ones. We're just going to use its automatic settings. So again, this is Synergic, and we're going to have a look at how it welds now compared to the other mode. So
Very nice. Yeah. So
what are some of the things coming off like with a pulse machine that you like against the normal welding types?
So it's obviously a lot easier to control the heat, much better finish in the weld. It seems to break up that oxide layer a lot easier. Just a much nicer finish and consistent weld.
So the heat can be a really big thing with aluminium. Unlike steel, aluminium doesn't really like to give us any warning when it's getting too hot. Is that a pretty fair
You can sum it up that way. Certainly. So.
Steel has a nice tendency to go red, and you know that you're starting to get to that point where you could have a hole blow through on thinner jobs or blow out a corner. But with aluminium, you notice it when it starts already falling through.
Mm.
So there are some little signs to stick out for, but it's nice to have a machine like this that fills in the blanks. Now that we've got double pulse on, it'll sound a bit different as well. If we can just cap off, Angus, just roughly, where do you reckon single pulse really sits in the market? Like, what kind of job would you do with that?
Most jobs. I mean, you're still going to get a really aesthetically nice looking weld. You got your heat control benefit of the pulse, so it suits, most applications.
With the double pulse, where would we see that?
So if you really want to hone in that, weld and get it looking really sharp, it really comes in its own for those super detailed welds and aesthetically pleasing welds,
definitely shows, man. Like, yeah. You can see between the two how the double pulse just, it looks nice.
Yeah, it's nice and consistent and pretty, so.
All right, so we've done a fair bit of mucking around with different types of welding today. Just to cover off on what we've done here, we've done some basic aluminium MIG welding where we've just changed over the rollers and the liner, thrown a roll of aluminium wire in, and we're off and racing. We've done spool gun setup for someone that wants a little bit more distance between the machine and the job and doesn't really want to play around with changing liners and rollers. We've done some synergic welding for somebody with a more advanced machine that'll do the settings for them. And we've also covered off on the pulse MIG for somebody that really wants to get into it with a bit more fancier machine. So it's been really good to get a chance to go through all of this. Thanks, Angus, for lending us the workshop and giving a chance to show some guys how to get into aluminium welding.
Yeah, no, it's been great, Will. Thanks for having me. And it was, great playing around with the machines. And
awesome. Well, thanks, guys. I really appreciate your time. Have fun doing it at home. I'll see you next time.